I'm a senior here at Wabash College. I'm an offensive lineman. I'm a classics major with a history and education double minor from Muncie, Indiana.
Founded in 1832, Wabash is a private liberal arts college whose mission is to educate men to think critically, act responsibly, lead effectively, and live humanely. The college sits on 65 wooded acres, minutes from the heart of downtown Crawfordville, a stellar community city of approximately 15,000. For nearly 200 years, Wabash has educated countless doctors, lawyers, business leaders, teachers, scientists, and entrepreneurs. Wabash men take great pride in learning and singing the nation's longest fight song, Old Wabash. Wabash's 870 students come from 27 states and 20 countries. Student conduct is governed by the gentleman's rule, which says the student is expected to conduct himself at all times, both on and off the campus, as a gentleman and a responsible citizen.
So the gentleman's rule for us is essentially the way of life. You know, you see it at a lot of schools, it's rule book after rule book, you know, the do's and the don'ts. But for us, it's pretty simple. We got the gentleman's rule. You know, I will conduct myself as a gentleman at all times on and off campus, no matter where it's at. So it's kind of something that's, it's a way of life and it's kind of a guiding principle. Oh yeah, no, if I was talking to myself senior in high school and I was on the fence about Wabash, I would tell myself if I didn't go, I'd be an idiot. The experience is overall, but just kind of that struggle and that like discomfort you experience at times, it pushes you so much to kind of, you know, force yourself to grow and kind of find new ways to get around new obstacles. Being a men's college, I would say, is one that means it's tough. It's gonna force you into some uncomfortable spaces. It's gonna make you grow. And along with growing, there's gonna be a lot of reflection. You're gonna have moments where you gotta think about what you're doing, how you're doing it, and kind of where you want to go. On top of that, being a men's college is something that not a lot of people, I think, at the age of 18 can make a choice to do. You know, when you're 18, you don't want to go to an all-male school. You know, people are going to give you a bunch of stuff about it. They're going to say this, that, and the other. But it's something that's where that reflection begins at that young age. Is it something that's worth it? Is it something that I want to do? And is it going to have a benefit that's, you know, long-term, not short-term? If you're on the fence, give it a shot. But it's one of those things where the benefit and the reward of attending this college, and like I say, it's a college for men. You know, you'll show up a boy, and by the time you're done with that first year, you're going to be different. That growth is something that I'm going to cherish because it's, you know, it's defined me in many ways.